Hello everyone, good day to all. I welcome all my dear kids to today's online live classes. I'm Pushpashri, faculty of Battenberg Tutorials. I'll be handling mathematics for Navodaya signing as well as RMS school entrance exam. So well, my dear kids, in this today's session, let us solve some of the problems based on unitary method. So in the last session also, we were solving the same kind of problems. So let us continue in today's session, the same kind of problems with the same chapter. So come, let's move on to today's class. So you can copy the question along with me. Take down the question for today. The first question, six men, complete a piece of work in four days. We'll stop and continue the question. In how many days, two men will complete. Two men will complete the same work. So this is your question. So see to your question once, then we'll move on to the solution. So six men complete a piece of work in 4 days. So how many people are there here? So there are six men. And this six men is going to complete the work in 4 days. Okay. They're having one piece of work. To complete that one particular piece of work, they are going to take 4 days. And in how many days, two men will complete the same work? If two men are working together. So if six men are working together, they're going to take 4 days to complete a particular work. So in the same way, if two men are working together, how many days will they take to complete the work? So this is your question. So in question, what they have given, only this information and this information is been given to you. What you have to find, you have to find days. What kind of days? If two men are working together, how many days will they take to complete a particular work? So this is what you have to find out here. So let us move on to the solution now. So the first part will be, so whatever the things they have given in the question, I'll just write that. Six men will complete the work in how many days? In 4 days. So this is your first part of the question. Okay. So if six men are working together, they are going to take 4 days. So here what we have to know first, how many days that one man is going to take. So one man will complete the work in how many days? 6 men. It's going to take 4 days. That means one man is going to take 24 days. So you can ask me, ma'am, how can it be 24? We have to divide 6 by 4, right? No, we should not do that. See here, 6 men, there are 6 people are there and they are working together. when there are so many people are there and these so many people are working together, the number of days that they are going to work is going to become decreased. Say for example, so there are four people and four people will be writing the notes, a particular notes. Say for example, 100 pages notes, they need to complete it full. So how many days these four people is going to take to complete that one particular notebook? Say for example, 2 days. How many four people can complete it in 2 days? See here. So 25 pages will be written by one person. Another 25 pages by one person. 25 pages another one by the third person. Again another 25 pages by fourth person. So if they all are working together, these are all the page numbers, pages, how much that they are going to write. Say for example, first person is going to write for 25 pages, second person is going to write 25 pages, third person is going to write 25 pages, and fourth person is going to write 25 pages. So if each and everyone are writing 25 pages per day or per hour, so they are going to take 2 days to complete that. So one person is going to take half a day to complete that. Another person is going to take half a day. Third person is also going to take half day. Fourth person is also going to take half day. So totally they will complete this particular 100 pages notebook in 2 days if four people are working together. So in the same way, if only one person is there, and he need to write 100 pages book. So one person need to write 100 pages book. So since there are four people, it is 2 days. So one person, it is 8 days. So since there are so many people are there here, the days will decrease. So since there is less people here, only one person, the days will increase. So the same example, you can refer with this problem. If 6 men is there, they are going to complete the work in 4 days. If 6 people, 4 days. Correct. So one person, how many days? 24 days. Fine. So this is how you need to analyze the question. Not blindly 6 by 4, you people should not do that. Okay. 6 into 4, 24 days. So one person is going to take 24 days now. So now, how many days 2 men will complete the same work? Therefore, 2 men will, complete the same work in 24 divided by 2 is equal to 12 days. Ma'am, why we just did the division over here? Why can't we multiply here? Because see, if one person is working for 24 days, two people is going to take divided by 2. So if two people is going to take 12 days, okay? So here you can apply the formula, fine? So therefore, so I can conclude here, therefore, so how can I conclude? Therefore, two men will complete the work in 12 days. So this is your answer. See here, again I'll explain you, listen to it carefully, okay? So 6 men complete a piece of work in 4 days. To complete one piece of work, so 6 men are there and they are taking 4 days to complete that particular piece of work. So in how many days 2 men will complete the same work? If 2 men are working together, only 2 people are working together, how many days will they take to complete that particular work? So this is your question. So when I move on to the solution part, see to the solution. 6 men will complete the work in 4 days, as they have already given in the question. So one man will complete the work in. So if 6 men are working, they are taking 4 days. So one man is going to complete the particular work in 24 days. That is 6 into 4. 6 fours are 24. So 2 men will complete the same work in 24 divided by 2. So 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. So 12 days. Therefore, 2 men will complete the work in 12 days. So this is your answer. So you can copy down this problem now. Copy down. Oh, fine. Hope you all copy down this problem. We'll move on to the second problem. So now we'll move on to the second problem for today. Copy down the question along with me now. How many packets of 25 gram How many packets of 25 gram each can be made out of 3 kg of sugar. So this is your question. So see to your question once. How many packets of 25 gram? So how many gram is there here? So here it is 25 gram. So there should be some packets. So each and every packet should be of 25 gram. Say for example, this is the packet and this packet has to be of 25 gram only. Each can be made out of 3 kg sugar. So there is one big bag with me here, big packet. So there is of 3 kg sugar in this packet. So what is there in this packet? So there is of 3 kg sugar in this packet. And here I need to, out of this 3 kg sugar, I need to prepare 25 gram each packets. So how many packets can I do with this 3 kg of sugar? So this is your question. So there is one 3 kg of sugar, that is of separate packet, and you need to prepare 25 gram separate packets out of this 3 kg packets, out of this 3 kg sugar. So if you are making 25 gram each separate packets, so how many packets that you can make out of this 3 kg sugar? So this is your question. So hope you all understood the question. I'll go with the solution now. So see to the solution. 3 kg. So solution. So 3 kg is equal to. So since here it is a gram, let me convert kg to gram. So how to convert kg to gram? So 1 kg. 1 kg is equal to 1000 gram. Correct. So in the same way, 3 kg is equal to 1000 into 3 is equal to 3000 gram. So 3 kg is equal to, now for me it is 3000 gram. Got it? So 1 kg is equal to how many grams? 1000 grams. So therefore 3 kg is equal to 1000 into 3. So it is of 3000 gram. So now 25 gram should be of how many packets? 1 packet. 25 gram is equal to 1 packet. That means 1 packet has to be filled with 25 gram itself. So therefore 1 gram is equal to. So 1 gram is equal to 1 by 25 packet. that is nothing but 1 gram should be there. That means out of these grams, how many grams that you are having. So in one packet, there should be 25 gram and you have to make the packets in it. How, see here. So one packet, 25 gram is equal, you have to make it into a packet. That means each and every packet should be consisting of 25 gram itself. How many packets you have to do? So therefore 3000 gram is equal to how many packets that you have to do? 1 by 25 into 3000. 1 by 25 into 3000. So what we have to do it next? So 25 divided by 3000. See here, 25 divided by 3000. 25 ones are 25. 30 minus 25, it is 5. Take this 0 down, 50. 25 twos are 50. And the remainder is 0. Take this 0 down now. So 25 zeros are 0. And the remainder is 0. So your answer is now 120. So 120 packets can be made out of this 3000 grams. Got it now? 120 packets can be made out of 3000 grams. See to the question once again, I'll explain you. See here, how many packets of 25 grams? So you have to make 25 gram packets each out of the 3 kg of sugar. So there is one bag of 3 kg sugar next to you and there are some packets over here, covers. What you have to do? You have to take out the sugar and put into each of the packet. Each of the packet weight should be of 25 gram itself. Fine. So that's what they are asking you in the question. So when I move on to the solution part, 3 kg I am having in the question, but here it is a gram. Since it is in a gram and that is in a kg, convert the kg into gram. How to convert? See, 1 kg is equal to how many grams? 1000 grams. So since therefore 3 kg is equal to 1000 into 3 is equal to 3000 grams. So 3 kg is equal to 3000 grams. So therefore 25 gram should be there in each of the packet. That means one packet should consist of 25 gram. So one packet should consist of 25 gram. So therefore 3000 gram. So how many gram? 3000 gram. That means 3 kg of sugar has to be filled in one packet, as each packet consists of 25 gram. So 1 by 25 into 3000. Divide 25 and 3000. 25 ones are 25. Remainder is 5. Take this 0 down. 25 twos are 50. Again the remainder will be 0. Take the another 0 down. 25 zeros are 0. So 120 packets can be made out of this. How many gram? 25 gram. Got this? So now, ma'am, how we will get to know whether the answer is correct or not? There is one verification. So I'll be doing the verification here. So working note. So how many packets that we have completed? 120 packets, right? So each packet consists of how much? 25 gram. 25 zeros are 0. 25 twos are 50. 0, 5 carry. 25 ones are 25 plus 5 is equal to 30. Is it 3000? And you got this 3000 and 3000, 3000. And your answer is correct. And this is your working note. Okay. So this is how you need to verify your answer, whether it is correct or not. Okay. So 120 packets should be there. 120 into how many grams each packet should be? 25 grams. 25 zeros are 0. 25 twos are 50. 0, 5 carry. So 25 ones are 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 3000 is to be filled in 120 packets. On first.